Documentary evidence indicates that a settlement may have existed at Europa Point during Gibraltar's medieval Moorish period, between 700 and 1462. Corral del Fez, as it was known, was established during the Merinid dynasty, when the Emir Abul Hassan constructed defensive walls all the way to Europa Point, making previously unsecured areas open for settlement.
In 1333, it's Malik who captures Gibraltar in the name of his father, and under Abul Hassan, Malik's father, the decision is taken that Gibraltar will never fall again to the Spanish. And so they decide to fortify Gibraltar as much as possible. So that's when all the building works happen. And there are documents that say that a line wall was built all the way up to Europa Point. And this is the first evidence that we found in Europa Point of that particular line wall, dating to that period.
Previous archaeological finds in the area close to the shrine of Our Lady of Europe, such as the 14th century Moorish guardhouse and nun's well, indicate settlement at Europa Point, but the discovery of the Merinid wall is significant.
We have documentary evidence from maps and other sources that there was or may have been some sort of settlement in this area, but we hadn't found any significant finds, so we weren't really sure. Until we found the Moorish wall, which is important because it indicates that there's probably other structures in the area as well.
Meanwhile, an important discovery at Four Corners, a structure believed to be an old circular tower known as the Torre del Molino.
So we were always aware that there was a tower in the vicinity of North Front. We obviously knew about the Devil's Tower because that survived until the mid-20th century. But when the foundations to this tower were found, they were a complete surprise, and we were very excited because at the beginning we didn't know what it was and we thought it was a cistern, and eventually the information that was coming through, the way it was being constructed, pointed in the direction of La Torre del Molino. And then when you actually look at it in the maps, it is more or less in the right area. So, you know, it's unlikely to be any other structure because there's no other large structure found.
The government and museum archaeologists have worked together with construction workers to ensure any part of Gibraltar's heritage is protected.
It means that we can be on the ground, we can find these items, we can take it to the museum, and it obviously adds to the history of all of us.
What happens to the wall and the artifacts now?
So the artifacts, when they're found, we obviously do all our archaeological work, all our reports. The actual finds are taken to the museum for processing, and the actual wall is now protected. Obviously, it's covered up, but essentially it'll be there for future generations, just in case in the future we want to open up the area and carry on with any work that we see fit.
There's still much to discover beneath our feet, but each construction project offers an opportunity to dig deeper into the rich tapestry of Gibraltar's history.